Hi, my dear children. Good morning to all. Welcome to Maths Online class. In the previous video, we were discussing on addition of large numbers. Now, today we are going to deal with subtraction of large numbers. The topic subtraction is very familiar to you. Now, today we can practice subtraction of large numbers with more examples. Now, we can discuss with subtraction. First example, 6. The two numbers are given here, 6,70,812, 3,456. The first rule of subtraction means we can subtract a smaller number from a larger number. So, always write first the larger number. So, from this, by looking itself, we can see which is the larger number. Here, since the two numbers are having different number of digits, we can compare it easily. This is a 6-digit number and this is a 2-digit number. So, which is the largest number? Yes, the 6-digit number, that is 6,70,812, is the largest number. So, that we write first. Then, 3,456. So, these large number and the other number we are subtracting have a name. What are they? That larger number is known as minuend. What is it? Minuend. And the smaller number that we are subtracting is known as subtrahend. So the larger number from which we are subtracting is known as minuend, and the smaller number which is subtracted is known as subtrahend. Now the answer of the subtraction is known as difference. Now how can you subtract it? Subtracting. Here, comparing the digit in one space. Here it is 6 and here it is 2. So, we have to subtract 6 from 2. Can we subtract 6 from 2? No. So, here we have to borrow from the next digit. What is the next digit here? 1. So, from the very next digit, we are borrowing. So, here the digit is 1. So, if I borrow 1, what is remaining here? Nothing. 0. And this 1 is shifted to here. This 1 means what is the place value of this 1? 10. So, 1 tens is shifted to here. That is why this 2 become 12. Now, you can subtract 6 from 12. Isn't it? So, 12 minus 6. What is 12 minus 6? So, 12 minus 6 is 6. Now, I told here we borrowed from this 1, so this 1 becomes 0, isn't it? Now, we cannot subtract 5 from 0. So, again, the process of borrowing. So, borrowing from the very next digit, that is 8. So, canceling from 1, 8. 8, 1 borrowing from 8, we have 8 changes to 7. Then, this 0 changes to 10. Now, 10 minus 5, what is 10 minus 5? So, what is 8 minus 4? No, 10 minus 5? 5. Now, here we borrowed from 8. What is having here? 7. So, here this 8 will not remain, but instead 7. So, 7 minus 4? 3. Now, the next digit, 0. Can we subtract 3 from 0? No. So, again borrowing, 7 becomes 6. So, this 0 becomes 10. So, 10 minus 3, 7. Here, 6. Here, there is no number. So, understand it is 0 here. So, 6 minus 0, 6. Here, again, the same procedure. Here also, 6. So, we got the answer. 6,67,356. Now, we have to confirm our answer is correct. How can we check the answer of subtraction? I told what the answer we are getting is difference. So, in order to check our answer, the answer we got plus the subtrahend, this number, we should get what? Minuend. If you are getting minuend correctly, then our subtraction is correct. So, we will check whether our answer is correct. So, I told how we are checking, adding the difference and subtrahend, we should get the answer minuend. So, what is the difference here? 6,67,356 plus minuend means 3456. Adding 6 plus 6, 12. Here 1 carry over, 5 plus 5, 10 plus 1, 11. 1 carry over. Then again adding 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 1, 8. No carry over. 7 plus 3, 10. 0 here, 1 carry over, 6 plus 1, 7, 6 writing the 7. So we got 6,70,812. This is our minuend, isn't it? So our subtraction is correct. So after subtracting, how we have to confirm our answer is correct? How? Adding the difference with the subtrahend, we should get minuend. Example, we are having two numbers here. So first step is compare the number which is larger. That you have to write first. So here counting, here we are having 6 digit. Here also counting, we have 6 digit. So both numbers are having same number of digits. So how can we compare? Go for the first digit. Here 6, here also 6. So go for the next digit. Here 6, here 4. So 6 is the large, which is the larger number? 6. So this is the larger number. So read it. 6,62,233. This number 6,40,403. So now we can subtract. Subtracting, I wrote the larger number first, then the smaller number. Now subtracting. Here 3 and 3 same. So 3 minus 3, 0. Here's 3, here 0. So this is the larger number. So you can subtract. So 3 minus 0, 3. Next, here 2, here 4. 4 is the larger number, so we cannot subtract. So we have to borrow from the very next digit. The very next digit is 2. So borrowing 1 from 2, what we have remaining here? 1. So this 2 becomes 12. Now 12 minus 4. What is 12 minus 4? 8. Now 1, here 0. So no need of borrowing. So 1 minus 0, 1. Now 6 minus 4, 2. 6 minus 6, 0. So you got the difference, 21,830. I said we have to check. So checking, 21,830, that is our difference, plus subtrahend, 6,40,403. Adding 0 plus 3, 3. 3 plus 0, 3. 8 plus 4, 12. 2 you wrote here, 1 carry over. Now carry over plus 1, 1 plus 1, 2. 4 plus 2, 6. Writing this 6. So you got 6,62,233. That is our minuend. Example, 68,785, 8,50,000. Now by seeing itself, you can see that which number is greater. Here you have only 5 digit. Here you have 6 digit. So which is the larger number? This is the larger number. So first we have to write this number. Then we have to write the next number. Here, see the case. Here, first 4 digits are coming as 0. So here when you are subtracting 5 from 0, you cannot subtract. So we have to borrow. When we are looking for borrowing, here it is 0. Can we borrow anything from 0? No. Again, here all are 0. So what we have to do? If we are not getting a value from the next digit, we have to move for the next digit. Again moving, we are having 0. So again moving to the next digit, here also 0. So here again we have to move. Next digit is 5. So from this 5 you are borrowing. So from this 5 if you are borrowing, this 5 becomes 4. And the very next 0 becomes what? 10. Now from this 10 you are borrowing to the next 0. So that 0 becomes 10. Like that. Till here you are borrowing. So I said from this 5 we are borrowing. So 5 becomes 4. So first this 0 becomes 10. Now from this 10 we are borrowing to the next 0. So this 10 we are again borrowing from this 10. So this 10 becomes what? 9. So this 0 becomes 10. Now from this 0 you are borrowing here. So this 10 becomes what? 9. And this 0 becomes 10. Now from here you are borrowing to here. So this 10 becomes 9 and here 10. Now there is, we are, again we need not give. So 10 minus 5, 5. Here what we have? Not 10 but 9. 9 minus 8, 1. Again we have here 9. 9 minus 7, 2. Then 9 minus 8, 1. Then it is 4 here, isn't it? We borrowed 1 from 5, so it is 4. So we cannot subtract 6 from 4. So again here borrowing, 8 becomes 7 and this 4 becomes 14. Now 14 minus 6, 8. Here 8, 1 is borrowed. So what is remaining here? 7. So you got the answer. 7,81,215. Now how will you check our subtraction? How can we check? Adding the difference with the subtrahend. So 7,81,215 plus 68,785. Adding 5 plus 5, 10. Writing 0, 1 carry over. 8 plus 1, 9. Adding the carry over, 10, 0 here. 1 carry over again. 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. 0 here. Carry over again, 1. 8 plus 1, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. Again, 1 carry over. 6 plus 8 is 14. 14 plus 1, 15. 1 carry over. 7 plus 1, 8. So we got the minimum. 8,50,000. Next example. Find the difference between 7 lakh and 1,11,111. So the question may come in this order also. So if, when you're getting the question like this, you have to compare which is the larger number first. So which is the larger number? By looking itself, we can say 7 lakh is the larger number. So first we wrote 7 lakh. Then the next number, subtracting. Here it is the case of 0, isn't it? So here all the digits we are having 0. Here one only number. So for this all digit we have to borrow from 7. So 7 becomes 6. Now this 0 becomes first 10. Then from this 10 borrowing, so it becomes 9. Again this 0 becomes 10. Then 9. Again, this 0 becomes 10, 9, 10, 9, here. Now here there is no need of again giving. So this number is 10 itself. 10 minus 1, 9. 9 minus 1, 8. Again 9 minus 1, 8. 9 minus 1, 8. 9 minus 1, 8. 6 minus 1, 5. Why here 6? Because we all borrowed from 7, so it becomes 6. So 6 minus 1, 5. So what answer we got? 5,88,889. So how we can check? By adding these numbers. Now in your textbook, one easy method means there one alternate method they are explaining. That is how means the two numbers are 7 lakh and 1,11,111. This case is only applicable when we have like this 0. Otherwise, they are not using it. So when we have the 0, like this numbers if you get, just take the predecessor of both the numbers. What do you mean by predecessor? Yes, the number before. So what is the number before 7 lakh? What is the number before 7 lakh? The number before 7 lakh is 6,99,999. Similarly, the next number's predecessor also you have to take. So, what is the predecessor of this number? 1,11,110. Now, subtract between these two numbers. When you are subtracting, you are getting the same number. It's not compulsory that you have to learn this method. Any method you have to know. If those who are following this method can follow this method. Okay. Now coming to the end of the session, today we discussed on the subtraction of larger numbers. The strategy of subtraction for smaller and larger number is same. Practice subtraction of numbers with more examples. Copy down the notes attached and attend the test paper given. We will meet in the next video with another concept. Thank you.